Yeah, we're all trained. Our background is in studio art, art history, and science and chemistry. So we bring all those things to each project that we work on. And we always work in tandem with the curator and the scientist, and we all bring our own areas of expertise to what we're looking at and come to some sort of decision on how something should be restored. You'll get the occasional person who comes to the profession through the sciences. It's a little bit more rare, but most of us are studio art or art history majors. And regardless, you still have to have the skills of the other two areas. So that weeds a lot of people out, because you're thinking from the left and right side of the brain.
Here's another example of a drawing with a lost edge, probably lost to mice. And this is an antique paper fill that I did. Right now there's a show coming up in the spring that I'm starting to work on now. We try and work pretty far in advance of the exhibits. So the curators, you know, in this case it's an in-house show. The provisional title is "It's a Zoo in Here." And it's going to be all about animals. I think the kids will love it, and I think it's opening in March or April. But anyway, that's why I have the big Brachamon rooster here, and the horse is drawing the plow. And I've got another 30 or so in the drawer, and we've already reviewed the first half of the show, and I'll go back and look at the creator, look at the rest of them.
You can see in the area, kind of like down here, put in little pink, patches, brown patches, just to kind of match it up and make it a little bit more visually complete. So it's a bit more understandable to the viewer. My name is Howard Sutcliffe, and I'm the textile conservator at the Detroit Institute of Arts. They are late 18th century Venetian opera characters, and the entire surface is then covered in nylon net, which is dyed to match. And also in the case of the coat, because it's so three-dimensional, to get it to hug the figure, I had to coat it with a very fine adhesive layer. And also because it's so fragmentary, I mean, I would just pass a needle through this thing and it would kind of fracture. So using an adhesive support in combination with stitching was really the only thing that I could do. Obviously there's been degradation through use over the years, and so it's been repaired, and so a lot of the old repairs I had to leave in place because they were just so numerous and so intensive. And it's kind of nice too that you have that evidence of use in there and what other people have done.
Share what we both discovered, then revel in.